Welcome back to Programming with Qt Widgets. In this episode, we'll talk about Qt's support for regular expressions. If you ask yourself now, what is a regular expression? Well, it will be rather a long episode if I need to teach you about regular expressions, but there is a few good resources that can teach you about regular expression, among other things, a whole book on the subject from O'Reilly. In this episode, I'll tell you how Qt support regular expressions. It does so via a class called QRegularExpression. It's amazing, isn't it? If you're looking in your code, and you find that you're using a class called QRegEps, I think it was called that way in the earlier days, then you likely have an old code base, and you might want to upgrade to QRegularExpression, which was new already in Qt 4 or at least in Qt 5. So it's a rather old transition. It was a complete rewrite of the regular expression engine, among other things, adding a lot of support for the regular expression. So QRegularExpression is what we have, and you might know regular expression from tools like Seed or Org or Perl, and Perl is the most powerful one of those, at least those three, ancient tool from Unix, and Qt basically does the same amount of regular expression that Perl does. It has some very odd use cases that is not supported by Qt, like executing some Perl script as part of the parsing, which obviously is not possible with Qt, but aside those, it has all of the support. It can look behind and look ahead and lots of other facilities. What QRegularExpression offers you are two things, basically. It offers you to just tell whether a regular expression or a string matches a regular expression, which is useful in, for example, a Q validator that we saw earlier in this video series here, where we could simply specify a regular expression for what kind of input we accepted in a line edit. The other thing you can do with QRegularExpression is to ask the regular expression to take your string and tear it apart and find subcomponents in there. And for that, we have QRegularExpression or QRegularExpression match, that's the match of asking regular expression to look at it. And it will give you the facility of fetching these individual captured parts of your regular expression. If you're asleep already and is at the urge of, Jesper, stop just talking, show me some code, well, you are in luck. Because right now, I'll show you an example of a regular expression. What you have here is a regular expression Rx, and it's this monster here. And if you're asking yourself, what does that really do? Well, let me show you a small trick. Well, I'll show you that in just a second. What it does basically is that it parses a date sender. Of course, it's a silly example, because if you want dates to be parsed, well, use qdate colon colon from string, and that will give you a Qt date object, but it's just an example. Please bear with me. Now, I can ask my regular expression to match this string here, and it will tell you true or false if it has a match. So this is in itself very useful, and you can see it matches all of these, and I can even ask if I have the other way around. If I already have a Qt string and I want to know whether it contains a regular expression, remember last episode we talked about qstrings, and it had a contained method that took a char qstring and a regular expression. String.containsRx will return true or false depending on whether it contains it. Let me show you the code running here just so that you trust that it actually works for me. Just pick some random stuff here. And here's the code. We can run it, compile it first, obviously. And while we're compiling, let's just look through the code here. It is a complete application. it uses QTbox to stream out the answers, and here is now it being run, a number of truths and a false and a true again. The last true, that's this one here. Yes, that matched 1971-07-11, which happened to be my birthday, just in case you want to send me a birthday gift, is the only right way in my world to specify a date. It says this old date. So what is a perfect date? She asked him, and the geek boy answers, well, ISO date is the only right date. Guess that was not what she asked. Oh, well, I'm not good at jokes, am I? I took that out again. So that's the regular expression. Let me show you how you can actually understand this. So if you're looking at this and say, what does that mean? Well, there is actually a good tool out there. Just cut and paste the whole thing here and go over to this little friend and simply ask him, her, it. Please explain this. I don't even need to specify more. I'll just please explain this, and ChatGPT will actually recognize it. This is a regular expression, and I'll zoom down here. This regular expression, blah, 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 is used to match date formats. You can figure that out. In the form month, month, date, date. Ooh, yes, that's why I prefer ISO dates, because is it month, month, date, date, or is it date, date, month, month? You guys over there in US, you would say it's this, and in Denmark at least, I would say it's date, date, month, month, or date, date, month, month. Ah, all those confusions. Hat, that's what we have here at the front of the string, is assert the start of the line. Backslash, backslash, D, question mark, matches 0 or 1 digit. So here, backslash D means a digit, and question mark means, well, 0 or 1. Another digit, a literal forward slash, and so on, until the end here. Well, we also have this in here. Digit, digit, question mark. That means that I can match 0 or 1 of this whole group, which means that I can match 71 or 1971, but not 971. Okay, so I cannot specify dates from, well, too bad. I just made up this example. Jesper, what's up with all those backslashes? Where did that voice come from? That, like, divine intervention? Oh, well, I'll tell you where all those backslashes come from. That's because I have a string here, and I need to escape that. ChatGPT told us that backslash D meant a digit, but that's not true. It's actually only backslash D that means a digit. So backslash is because I have a backslash. And there is, in 2011, a new version of C++ that introduced this raw string, which is really useful here. R, and then I need the parentheses on the inside here. And at the end here, like this. Now it's a raw string, and now I do not need to escape my backslashes anymore. Well, not only do I not need to, I shall not escape my backslashes anymore. And you can see the cool thing about raw strings is that even if I had a quote in there, it is not considering this the end of the string before it's a parenthesis end quote. And now you say, ooh, well, how about, well, go and read up on raw strings, how I can even have parenthesis end quote in my strings if I want to. Okay, I'll tell you. I can do like this here. The audio effect of is actually needed in there for that to work out. And now I can have, oh, well, see, I can now remember. Somebody smartass liked it will make a comment below telling about what exactly the right syntax is for this. In the meantime, I'll just compile my application, and you can see that my regular expression, which is way more easy to read now without all the backslashes, still result in the same output. And just to get focus away from that, I couldn't remember the right syntax here. Let's talk about one other thing. Why does it say static? Well, that's because we talked about it earlier. Our little friend called Clacy actually complains about regular expressions standing like this, because most of the time the regular expressions in here are just plain string that needs to be built. But what it needs to do is that it needs to parse it. It needs to create a just-in-time compilation unit of that and blah, 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 blah. So therefore, Clacy, still waiting for it, but it will come eventually. Clacy will tell me, hey, you should likely make this into a static to avoid every time you get into this function. Main, yeah, right. I only get into that once, but it could have been part of a tight loop somewhere where I was comparing a regular expression with a string, and I would not want to have to recompile it all the time. So Clacy suggests to me, make it static in there. Yes, I cannot live with the thought that somebody will have to tell me how it's done right. So I did right now. The XX or whatever string I have here needs to be the same on both sides. And it needs to go before the parentheses and after the parentheses down here. And now I can have my parentheses close and whatever in the string. If I run this, it'll take a while to compile because I'm also spending a lot of CPU recording my screen here. But once it is done and ready, and I'm just trying to stall time here, you'll see that, hey, I could not pass the regular expression. That's a compile time thing. Or, no, it's a runtime thing. I was just thinking of a conversation that happened in KDAB yesterday when I was asking about this static here, and there was somebody that found a compiled or a regular expression at compile time, and then the discussion went a long way discussing whether that was a good or bad idea. Anyway, Qt's regular expression is not compiling the regular expression at compile time, but at runtime, which is why we want the static in there. So it's useful to know that my string matches the format of a date, but often I want to actually know each part of what was matched. And for that, I can use my regular expression again. And as you see here in the code, static QRegularExpression, this regular expression that looks slightly different. And let me just highlight the difference for you. Now it says parenthesis open, parenthesis close, parenthesis open, parenthesis close, parenthesis, parenthesis. Well, this was the original parenthesis we had in there to make two-digit optional, but there's parenthesis here and parenthesis there. And what these do is that they mark part of my regular expression that I want to capture. So if I run my regular expression, I created a function here now called parse, and I call that parse a number of times to see if it works. And when I run my parse method here, I'll take my regular expression and match it on the string. And rather than just getting my regular expression object back and calling hasMatch, as we did here on the previous slide, just I got my regular expression object back from this match here and then just calling hasMatch, what I'll do is that I'll now actually store my match and test. Okay, so it was here on the next line. Test whether there was a match. And if there was a match, what I'll do is that I'll go to my regular expression and say match.captured1, .captured2, .captured3. This is where you'll go, captured1? What? Is this 1-based? No, don't worry. It's 0-based, but capture 0 is the whole string that was captured. Here it starts with a hat and ends in a dollar, which means that the whole string must be matched. But if it didn't, then it could have matched it just as a substring. And then the substring that was matched is in captured 0. And how about this one in here? Can I get to this one in case I wanted to? Yes, you can. That is captured 4. It is beyond my attention span, really, to know why this is 3 and this inside is 4. But go and just play with it and see which matches. What you also can do is that you can go and ask for captured text. And what that will return you is a string list. But now let's really go over and run the example. Let's just run the example so you can see the output of each of those captures. While we do that, notice that I'm actually using the right justified here and right justified a bunch of time here, which will give me, okay, that ruined it kind of a, because I have this Q string list here. The string list, that's the output of the match captured text. So the whole, this is capture 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I don't want to go captured 1, captured 2 and so on, I can just go and call captured text. But let me just comment this one out because that's what I wanted to show with the right justified here to make it visible, more appealing to you. I use these to make sure that the month aligns up here and the year lines up here, despite it being 07 and so on. And that's what I do with the right justified. So even if I capture just one character, I say, well, right capture, make it into a string of two characters long and right justify that one. We saw that API in the previous episode, and here is a good example of it. And you can see again, input this string here and so on, and they're all aligned here on the right, so that it's easy to see that 1-7 is day 1, month 7, and year 1971. You gotta love Qt. Write your software once, deploy it everywhere. Yeah, as if. There are so many things besides just compiling your software on a foreign platform. So if you're familiar with Windows or Mac or some Unix version, but not with the others, and you want to go there, reach out to us and we can help you. The final example of using regular expressions is if you have a string where you want to match several parts of the string to a regular expression. You can, of course, ask the regular expression to run on the whole string and then cut out the part that you matched and then run again. But you can also use QRegularExpressionMatchIterator for that. And I have an example here. And so I have a regular expression here that matches, well, I could go and ask our good friend ChatGPT what it matches, but actually this came from ChatGPT. I just asked it to create me a regular expression for matching email addresses. And then I have a subject here. Subject, that's not a subject in email subject. It's a subject of what I want to match. So I have a string. It could have been that I asked the user to type in a bunch of email addresses that I wanted to send emails to. And there is me in space and Jesper Pedersen at KDAB.com and at here and whatnot. And now I simply ask my regular expression to do a global match on this. I get a regular expression match iterator. God, I love that name. Thanks for auto completion. Out of that or auto. And then I simply iterate through it in a Java style where as long as I have next, then give me the next matched tier and I can do something with it. And let's just see this running over here. And you can see that it matches me in space and Jesper Pedersen, but it did not match at here, which is not a valid email address according to this regular expression up here. That was it for this episode in Programming with Qt Widgets. Regular expressions is a very powerful tool. It's one of those tools in my toolbox that I reach out from time to time to reach. It's a good way of limiting input in my line edit so that the user actually will not be mistyping something. There is nothing more annoying than a form that you fill in and then at the end of the form, you press OK and then a dialog box comes up and say, you know what? This is not an email address. You should have typed it in like this. Like, okay, why didn't you prevent me from typing in something that was not an email address to start with? And in just parsing my text in many different places, regular expression is a cool tool. If you don't know about regular expressions, go and read some of the resources available below. Otherwise, there are some pretty nifty pages up on the World Wide Web where you can type in and build up regular expressions. And as I showed you in this episode, ChatGPT is actually pretty good with regular expressions. There are lots of resources out there that it had learned from. So that's another useful tool. But as always with ChatGPT, be careful interpreting what it says. It might be just giving you utter Can I say that in this episode? Anyway, that's it. Until next time, have a great time.